Hello, wrestling fans. How are you? Here in the weapon of Monday Night Raw for May the 13th, 2024. The show opened up with Damian Priest being called out by Drew McIntyre. McIntyre first wanted CM Punk because CM Punk's medically cleared to compete. McIntyre's, but surprise, surprise, he no-shows again. He knew I was going to leave the arena last week. He waited till I left before he showed up. McIntyre said, don't worry, Punk. The day will come when I will kick your ass and put you on the shelf permanently. So he called out Damian Priest. He said, if it wasn't for CM Punk attacking me after my world title match against Seth Rollins at WrestleMania in April, you know I'll be standing here as world heavyweight champion. Damian Priest said, hey, admit something. If you had Money in the Bank briefcase, would you cash in like I did? And McIntyre said, yeah, I would. So Damian Priest said, what's the problem? If you badly want that chance at the world championship, I'll give it to you. I'll give you a rematch, Damian Priest said. You named the place and the time, and he walked right past McIntyre and left the ring. Went backstage and he told Finn Balor, JD Madugo, who was with Dominic and Kalito, who's still trying to join Judgment Day because he's scared of the LWO, Rey Mysterio's group, the faces there. Damian Priest told Kalito, like, hey, if you want to join us, you gotta earn it. You gotta earn your stripes. And we're not gonna let you in just to deal with your issues of the LWO. We don't like cowards. So prove to us you deserve to be in Judgment Day. They tell Finn Balor, JD Madugo, get you guys' ass out in that ring later on. Win that number one contendership fatal four-way tag for the Awesome Truths World Tag Team Championships. Then he said, somebody better go warn Braun Strowman not to mess with Judgment Day. JD Madugo's like, I got that. Like, that was hilarious. The opening match was the Queen of the Ring quarterfinal matchup. Shayna Baszler on a house show on the weekend defeated Maxine Dupree to advance the tournament. Selena Vega was pulled out of the tournament due to injury. Get well soon, Selena Vega. Shayna Baszler attacked Io Sky as Io was posing on the ropes. Just bent that arm sideways. She pulled up the ring apron and put Io's arm through like that metal stuff and just snapped it back and stomped on it, kicked on it, smashed into the ring post and a running knee into the arm. Io fought back, had a nice picture-perfect top rope drop kick, knocked down Shayna Baszler. Hit her Mia Rora in the corner. That was awesome. Then she did a sunset flip and went for the curb stomp. Shayna Baszler caught her, Kojiji Clutch chokehold. Io Sky flipped over and retransitioned into STF submission. Shayna powered out of it, sidewalk slam, running knee to the face, and I thought for sure that was it. Shayna Baszler was going to Shayna in my finals. But Io Sky kicked out. Knocked it down. Top rope moonsault. Your winner, Io Sky. She goes on to face the winner of the next match, Zoe Stark and Aubrey Valkyrie. Great match these two women put on. Zoe Stark had a nice leg sweep takedown. Had a nice rapid fire forearm shots. Like, one of them just drilled Aubrey Valkyrie. Like, she had to be seeing stars after that one. Valkyrie fought back with a running roundhouse kick. Spin kick to the midsection. Kick strikes back at Zoe Stark to the corner. Zoe caught her. Suplexed her in the corner, and then she got cocky, started mouthing off to her, trash talking, and she picked her up to deliver the go to sleep. The Valkyrie countered it, Falcon Arrow, your winner, and going on to face Io Sky in the semifinals the next week of the Queen of the Ring tournament on Raw. Aubrey Valkyrie, Io Sky, that's gonna be an amazing match. First time ever between those two win them. Next up, Sami Zayn was supposed to face Tozawa one-on-one, but instead, Chad Gable put Otis in the match. Bell rang. Otis knocked down Sammy. It was not on top, by the way. They did the caterpillar, and Chad Gable started mouthing off to him, like, hey, don't do that. Do this, do that. Otis wasn't paying attention. That made Chad Gable distract him. Sammy, a Lua kick, 1-2-3, quickly took off. Fast match. After the match, Chad Gable got in, started mouthing off to Otis, slapped him across the face, said, you're worthless. When's the last time you actually won a match? And stuff. Listen to me, I'm sick and tired of Alpha Academy losing. Sammy ran in, exploded, suplexed him in the corner, went for the Lua kick, but Gable rolled out of the ring. Then Otis followed him up the ramp. Bronson Reed was supposed to face Otis. Chad Gable put in a character Tozawa against Bronson Reed. Bell rang. Bronson Reed slammed him down. Tosami, 1-2-3, was over within seconds. So Alpha Academy there is losing big time. Becky Lynch non-title took on Dakota Kai of Damage Control, Kairi Sane, Io Sky. Great match these two women put on. Becky, once that bell rang, Dakota Kai had a running scorpion kick, stumps in the corner, choked her on the ropes with a leg, sent her outside, repeating smash her face into the ring post, repeating smash her face into the turnbuckles. Dakota Kai was just all over Becky. Becky finally got the offense going with a top rope drop kick. Then she positioned Dakota Kai between the ropes and delivered an atomic leg drop off the top rope. That was awesome across the back of Dakota Kai. She had her exploded suplex. Went for the rock bottom. Dakota Kai flipped over. Scorpion kick into the back. Then she went for her finisher. Becky Lynch countered that into an armbar submission. Transition to the Disarmer. Suddenly, Damage Control attacks. Becky won by disqualification. 301 beatdown until 2 weeks in a row now. Ollie Valkyrie made the save for Becky. Alongside Becky, they cleaned house on Damage Control. I want to keep saying Judgment Day there. I apologize. Then suddenly, Liv Morgan ran in and shoved Becky into the turnbuckle and took off. Becky made her pay afterwards. Backstage, Liv was like, hey, I'll do what I gotta do to become World of Women's Champion around here. Becky walked up and just smoked her ass. She said, thanks, bitch. And walked away. I loved it. I love that. Way to go, Becky. Fatal 4-Way Tag. The winners will face Awesome Truth for the Tag Team Championships. The Creed Brothers of Ivy Nile. Finn Bálor, JD McDougal, Pete Dunne, Tyler Bate, and the Office of Pain with the other lamest guys of the group. Before the match, JD McDougal approached Braun Strowman. So I got a message from you, from Damian Priest. Braun Strowman is talking to Creed Brothers. Like, what? What's the message? Don't piss off Judgment Day. And he left. Braun Strowman is like, whoa, I'm scared. Like, that was hilarious. Great Fatal 4-Way Tag. At one point, I love the action pack. During the match, Offers of Pain at one point just clotheslined everybody. Body slam, scoop slam, sent everybody tossed and like tossed them out of the ring. Then they grab a hold of poor JD McDougal, who just ended up getting suffered by a double team gut buster from Creed Brothers. Tossed him out of the ring onto everybody else. Then delivered super collider power bombs on Judgment Day. Brutus got in, broke up the pin there. Then he went for the Brutus ball, but Tyler Bate made the tags, so Brutus changed direction because he knew he just got tagged in. Tyler Bate did. And jumped off onto everybody else outside. That was hilarious. Tyler Bate got in, did that, like, go for the test of strength and punch him right in the mouth on a member of Offers of Pain. Then him and Pete Dunne took them outside, and then they did that awesome run-in, jump off out of a corner, standing moonsault to the outside onto everybody else. Judgment Day got their asses kicked. Then Finn Bálor squared off with Julius Creed at one point during the match and hit that runner drop kick in the corner. Went for the coup de grace. Julius Creed jumped up, superplex. Out of the corner, that was awesome, off the top rope. They had a running shooting star press. JD McDougal ran in, and he, alongside Finn Bálor, Julius Creed overhead suplex both guys. Like, he does that. He starts doing overhead suplexes. Gets the momentum going. Pete Dunne, Tyler Bate deliver a burning hammer on Finn Bálor. They had the match won. When suddenly, Carlito shows up, it costs them the match. They pose Tyler Bate outside the ring. Pete Dunne goes after Carlito. Then Pete Dunne changes, for some reason, instead of going after Carlito, goes after JD McDougal and starts punching him on the announce table. Carlito hit the backcracker on Pete Dunne on the announce table. Then he took off for the crowd. Back in the ring, after JD McDougal rolled Pete Dunne in the ring, Finn Bálor delivered the coup de grace for the 1-2-3. But I noticed during that, one of the Creed brothers was this close for sliding in the ring to break it up, but he didn't get there in time to break up the free count. Judgment Day is your winners. After the match, backstage, Damian Priest walks up to Carlito and says, your Judgment Day now. You helped us out. You earned your stripes. You're part of the crew now. But I'm telling you, he said, we are not going to help you against the LWO. You got to pull your weight. So Carlito's like, that's cool. That's awesome. Carlito's now a member of Judgment Day. Awesome. That is cool. Let me know below what your thoughts of Carlito joining Judgment Day. Is it temporary? Or is it going to be permanent? Kofi Kingston beat Rey Mysterio in a house show to advance into the second round of the King of the Ring tournament of Raw. He took on Gunther. He attacked Gunther before the match and just kicked his ass from pillar to post, like all over Gunther. Then Gunther ended it with a back body drop on the barricade. That back body dropped him on the announce table. Boston Crab submission on the announce table. Chops, smashed him in the ring post. At one point, he smashed him in the ring post and bent. Is it like try to bend him like a stretch him like a pretzel around the ring post? That was nasty as hell. Kofi fought back, top rope frog splash. Gunther kicked out. Kofi hit the boom drop. Gunther kicked out. Kofi went for a trouble in paradise. Gunther chopped him down. Powerbomb, Boston Crab, your winner by submission, Gunther. He goes on to the semifinals. After the match, Xavier Woods on crutches approaches Kofi Kingston backstage and says, "Hey, we got to do something, man. New Day is sucking right now." And he walks away. And then Kofi again delivers a kind of like a heel promo. And then Karrion Kross walks up to him and says, "Hey, my group could take you in. Like, I'd love to see a heel New Day. But don't put him in Karrion Kross's group. That would just destroy their careers and flush them down the toilet. Have New Day turn heel and just be New Day heel. Not with Karrion Kross's people." Sami Zayn was supposed to face Akira Tozawa, but Chad Gable sent Otis in. Within seconds after Otis hit the catapult, Gable was mouthing off to him not to do that. Otis wasn't paying attention, crashed and burned off the Vader bomb, as he always does. Alua kick, your winner, Sami Zayn. After the match, Chad Gable ran in, slapped Otis across the face, said he's worthless, he's sick and tired of working with him if he's going to keep losing. Sami attacked him, exploded suplex in the corner, went for the Alua kick, but Chad Gable rolled out of the ring. Then he ordered Otis to follow him up the ramp. Bronson Reed had a match. Supposed to be against Otis, but Chad Gable changed it up and sent in Akira Tozawa. Bell rang, power slam, Tsunami, 1-2-3, your winner, Bronson Reed. Nothing very exciting there. Your main event was main event Jey Uso against Ilyaf Dragunov for the first time ever in a second round King of the Ring qualifying match, with the winner of this to face Gunther. All match I was hoping for freaking Dragunov. I was. He was on fire, folks. Like, he was taking it to Jey Uso. Running uppercuts. Hit that. At one point, he went for the ground top rope forearm shot he does with the guys on the ground. Well, he did off the barricade. And Jey Uso moved out of the way and Dragunov hit the announce table. That looked nasty. Jey Uso dropped him on the announce table, which didn't break. Jey fought back. At one point in the match, after Dragunov delivered some chops and slaps and punches and kicks. Jey Uso fought back with super kicks, open hand palm strikes, Uso drop. Dragunov fought back, delivered a top rope, grounded forearm shot. Jey kicked out, went for a second one off the top rope. Jey speared his ass. Uso splash, your winner, Jey Uso. I was disappointed. I really wanted Dragunov to win, to have Dragunov versus Gunther, because that match those guys had at NXT years ago was amazing. But now we're going to have next week, it's going to be Gunther versus Jey Uso. Also next week, Ali Valkyrie versus Io Sky for the first time ever in the semifinals of the other tournament. Also announced for next week, it is Chad Gable versus Sami Zayn in a non-title match. There we have it, folks. Actually, I really enjoyed Raw a lot last night. I didn't care much for the fast matches of Alpha Academy, but I get it, because Chad Gable's trying to turn them heel and they still want to be faces. But the other matches, well, you got to check them out, folks. They were really good. I cannot wait for the semifinals. I'm still picking Gunther to win the tournament on the man's side. And the women's side, I really wanted Tiffany Stratton to win it, but I got a bad feeling Bianca Belair is going to beat her on SmackDown this week, which I don't want to happen. Stay safe, everybody. Too sweet. Bye.